Today I'm going to show you how to quilt a bubbly, wavy, frothy, free motion quilt design. Hi, I'm Kim Jamieson-Hirst of Chatterbox Quilts, and today I'm going to show you how you can take two simple free motion quilting designs, combine them together to come up with a new, fun, frothy, watery kind of design. So what you need to do here is do first one part and then the second part. And the first part is very simple. It's wavy lines. Very easy to do. And it's actually what I recommend you start with when you're first learning how to free motion quilt. So I'm just going to pull up my bobbin thread here. And I'm going to just lock my stitches. And then I want to stitch one wavy line. So I'm just going to stitch this down towards the end of my sample sandwich here. All right, so I've got one already stitched out, one wavy line stitched out. Then I want to go back and I want to echo this one about a quarter inch away. You don't have to be really precise with this one. I am going to try to match the curves of the one I've already stitched. But if you're not exactly, you know, echoing it perfectly, don't worry about it. You'll get the same effect. So I'm actually going to move over. I'm not breaking my thread. I'm just moving over a little bit. And I would typically do this in the seam line. Just about a quarter of an inch away, just eyeballing it. And then I'm going to go backwards, of course, and follow that line along. All right, so I've got my first set of wavy lines or echoed wavy line. So then the next thing I want to do is I want to leave some space because actually what I'm going to put in here is circles. And what I'm going to do though is I'm not going to put the circles in right now. I'm going to move over, leaving a bigger space, up to you how much you want to leave, but definitely a space that's more than the quarter inch you're seeing here. And then I want to do another set of those wavy lines. So I'm going to go over. Again, I'd be in the seam line. And then I'm going to do another set of wavy lines. Now, they don't have to be the same as the first ones I did. Like, I'm not trying to echo that in any way, shape, or form. I'm going to stitch the first wavy line, and then I'll try and echo it with the second one again. All right, there's the start of my second set of wavy lines. Go over about a quarter of an inch and then go back and echo that one I just stitched. All right, so there's my second set of wavy lines. Are you feeling seasick yet? Hopefully not, okay? I'm gonna do one more set of these because I wanna point out something that may help you when you're trying to stitch that second line. Okay, I'll do the first one. All right, so now I'm ready to go back and echo this line. And what I find helpful to do sometimes, and I'm not always perfect with it either, but that's perfectly all right, is that I will use the edge of my foot as I go along. So I'll try and run that edge along the previously stitched line so it'll give me an even spacing. Okay, so it's probably a little more than a quarter of an inch, but it allows me to easily follow along that first stitched line, especially when I'm going backwards. All right, so the next thing I want to do here, I'm going to break my thread. You don't necessarily have to do that, but I wanted to break my thread so that you can actually see what I'm starting with here. Okay, so there's my three sets. Now I've got this space in between, and I want to fill that up with circles or bubbles maybe in the water, right? So what I would do is, I could have just gone back along the seam. Let me pull this back out again for you to see. I could have just gone back along the seam and started filling in here, but I'm just going to start over at the front edge again. I would lock my stitches in the seam. So I'm going to use my hand wheel. Don't be afraid of using your hand wheel. And let me just see here. I got to move myself over a bit. Okay. To position your needle where you want it. I mean, why would they put a hand wheel on if we couldn't do something with it? Okay, let me just go back down there. There we go. I can lock my stitches again. Okay, and I want to start making a circle. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a circle somewhere in this area, and then I'm gonna make another circle, okay? So I'm gonna move these back and forth in this area. There's a few different ways you can do these. So I wanna show you one way in this space and another way in the next space. So let's try and get these going the way I want here. And then the other one I wanna put sort of over towards this side. And you can make these any size you want. You can position them in different ways if you want to. You could make them like all the same size. You could make them varying in size. That gives a lot of interest as well. And you notice I'm going around about 1.5 times. You also notice I'm not perfect with my back tracking. So depends on the day. Don't worry if you're not. Okay, so here's my little bubbles in there, in amongst the waves, all right? So you can see how those are all connected to each other and they're all going in a different direction offset. So you could have them all the same if you wanted, but I think this gives a more organic look. Now the other thing you can do is if you don't want to have your bubbles or your circles attached to one another, you can leave a little bit of space between them and you can attach them with a very short wavy line. So this time I'm going to stitch them with a little bit of a wavy line in between to show you what that looks like. All right, so here we have the ones that have, you know, it's just a little bit of a wavy line. You can have them, you know, going in different directions and that. So you could do that as well. Now in this particular space, I probably should have made them a little bit bigger to fill in that space, but you know, you can always go back and add more if you wanted to, if you think it looks like it needs it. So this is a really easy design to make. Great for kids' quilts. Works great in borders, of course, and sashing as well. So if you are wanting to look for something that gives a frothy look to your quilt, why don't you try out this design? Thanks so much for watching today. I have another video for you on a similar topic to take a look at. And if you want more helpful quilting information, please go to my website at www.chatterboxquilts.com. And remember, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe and hit the bell so you'll be notified the next time I release a new video. Okay, so yeah, this is supposed to be a bookmark. It's not supposed to be a cat toy. No, bookmark mine, not yours.